Dear Arthur, I've written this letter 100 times or more, and I cannot get it right. It's me. You know it's me from the bad handwriting. I know I said when we last spoke and I was going off to get married that we would not speak again. I know I said a lot of things, and I meant them, I suppose, at the time. But I'm not so proud as to not speak to people who care for me, or cared for me. I've been in Valentine for a couple of months. I had some bad luck, and, well, it's a long story and not an interesting one. But I am here for now. I saw a couple of the girls, or whatever the polite term is for them, that ran with you and your associates in town. And I heard tell of a man who sounded like you. I would love to see you again if you could spare me a little bit of your time. I'm renting a room at Chadwick Farm, just north of Valentine. Yours, Mary Linton.
A seat and a swig, Arthur.
All right.
What a delightful surprise.
Hello, Karen.
Hello, Miss Grimshaw. How's your meal? Fine. I'm so glad. You know, while we were stuck up that mountain, I thought long and hard about if we'd have to eat you. I suggested we roasted you alive. Mr. Pearson was keener on chopping you up and turning you into stew. Said he couldn't bear to see your face for even one moment longer than he had to.
You're quite the amusing companion, aren't you?
I like to think so.
A little advice.
You and Sean seem to enjoy the party, then?
Oh, shut up.
What did I say?
A stew without good meat is no stew at all, Mr. Morgan.
Actually, I'll come back to you later, okay?
I've come up with some ideas for ways we could improve things around here if you want to take a look. Ah, yes, that'll be much appreciated. Guess we'll see if anyone notices.
I am not well. I think I'm dying. I need...
If you are dying, how do you plan to repay me?
Oh, you are a heartless little swine. You really are.
It is for his own good, Mr. Morgan.
I'm sure.
You happy to have Uncle Sean back?
Yeah, I missed him.
Well, that makes one of us. Everything okay, Miss Grimshaw?
Yes, finally about done cleaning up after that party.
You people want to eat or not?
Real shame about them calendar boys, I reckon.
Sure.
You know, I once saw Max beat up 15 sailors. That ain't nothing. Everybody knows them Navy boys can't fly.
Hey, Javier.
I heard about a house. Could be interesting.
What kind of a house?
I don't know. A couple fellas I heard in town, they said it was really freakish. A family local boogeymen, I guess. But they're crooked in every way.
So?
Well, so these boys thought they were sitting on a lot of cash. They're highway robbers, kidnappers, apparently. They're well hidden in the woods.
That sounds pretty dubious.
Of course. Yeah, it's dubious, but there ain't much risk of getting caught.
Okay, then. Let's go take a look.
Exactly. Just take a look.
It's up north, on the other side of the river from Valentine. Best way there is through Cumberland Falls, though. You know it?
Sure, more or less.
Pretty close now. Let's stop and go on foot from here. Just up the hill this way. Follow me. There's a spot up ahead where we should be able to get a good look at the place. I want to make sure we don't run into any surprises.
Sure.
Apparently, this family's been isolated for so long, they started talking in their own weird dialect. They really don't like outsiders, especially on their turf.
Well, you just keep selling me on this job, don't you?
Oh, big place, right?
Well, there's a pretty big barn in the back. It's not a bad place to start looking. There must be a lot of people living here. A large house.
Stash could be in any one of them buildings, and who knows how many people are in there. I ain't sure about this.
Boy, I think we need to draw them out somehow, and I got an idea. Follow me.
All these trees, I can't get a proper look at the place.
Well, hopefully it'll make it harder for them to spot us, too.
Coast seems clear so far.
Yeah, so far.
Hey, keep it down. I hear voices. Come on, let's hide behind the shed. See if we can hear what they're saying. Just stay quiet.
Maybe you's hunted pig this time once, Mal. Where you been now, Newt?
Don't be boiling now, Pappy. I's gone but 10 minutes I was.
Can hollygag all the now day long, cause Edie takes patrol now, don't you?
What? No, Edie get all the jam!
You shut your gulper, or I'll flag her your felt, I will. You need to pull it up, boy. Up. Go guard the shed.
Go!
You understand what they're saying?
Not much of it. What are we doing, Javier?
Okay. You take cover by the rock over there. I'll create a little distraction, and then you jump them, okay?
What kind of distraction?
You'll see.
Thank you.
Let's look for the stash.
They weren't shy about defending that barn. Let's check in there first.
Under here. There's no place else I could store it. Hey, Arthur, give me a hand here. Do you want the money or not? Come on. We didn't come all this way for nothing.
Well, look what we have here.
I told you it was worth the trouble, didn't I?
Yeah, you take this. Let's split up. I'll meet you back at camp.
Sounds good.
Ain't no money in sloppy hunting.
You okay, boy? Hey, boy. Hey, mister.
Morning, partner.
We penny to get out of this, friend.
Hey,
ain't seen you in here before, mister.
Hey there, partner.
Morning there.
Sure thing.
You okay, boy?
Getting quick, folks.
Let's go, boy.
Hello.
Okay there?
How do you do?
Hey, mister.
Hello there.
Come on, there's gotta be a fight every night in that shithole.
Just show some respect next time. We've run far worse than you out of town before.
Oh, come on, man. Someone throws a punch, you punch back. Don't bother pretending different.
As far as I care, you ain't even here.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hello. Can't be around here.
Madam, back here.
Good morning.
Back off. Get the hell away from me. Will you move?
What the hell?
Calm down, will you?
Fine, you moron.
Hey, partner.
Morning, sir.
Yes?
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to disturb you, ma'am. Is Mrs. Linton in?
I'll go see. Mrs. Linton, a caller for you.
Hello, Arthur.
Mary?
I heard you and your friends was around.
Okay. Where's what's his name?
Died.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, me too. Happened a while ago. Pneumonia.
Bad business.
Sure.
So, you've been made a widow and you come here looking for me, is that it?
No, ain't like that, Arthur.
Ah, okay.
My family. I need your help.
You mean the family that always looked down on me? You want me to help?
It's my little brother, Jamie.
I always liked Jamie, at least compared to the rest of them.
He's broken Daddy's heart.
Daddy has a heart?
Don't make me beg you, Arthur.
My money, my life, me. I wasn't good enough.
I'm sorry. We need your help real bad. Little Jamie's joined the Chelonians, that strange religious order.
Good for him.
They're quite mad, Arthur. They'll kill him. You're the only person he'd listen to.
So, I'm too rough to marry into your family, but it's okay to ask me to help in saving your family.
I'm sorry. I understand if you don't want to help me, but I think of you often.
Long time ago now.
I'm begging you, Arthur.
I say let Jamie live Jamie's life and not the nightmare that his daddy dreamed up for him.
Jamie's so innocent, Arthur. Please, Arthur. Will you help me?
Where is he?
Somewhere out near Carmody Dell, I think. The rancher there said he'd seen him around the Cumberland Forest area. I just want him back. Arthur, if you find him, bring him to me at the station.
I'll see what I can do.
I'll owe you.
You already owe me.
okay, boy.
Hey, folks. Hello, mister.
Hello.
Finest meats here. Nowhere else.
Welcome. Little advice. Treat your game with respect. You get a better kill. Don't use 10 bullets when one will do. Even better, work on that bow and arrow.
Okay, boy.
Hey, mister.
Slow down.
Hey there.
Hello.
You, mister, excuse me.
You look like a man on a mission.
Hello.
Let me through! You know what? Forget about it.
You just all mouth, ain't you?
Whoa,
oh, hey, you there! Think you could help a lady out? My horse up and died on me, twisted my ankle something fierce. Think you could give me a ride?
Yeah, sure. Hop on.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you.
Stay up.
You know Emerald Ranch? Mind taking me there?
Sure.
Glad I ran into you. I raised that horse, you know. Raised it since it was just a foal.
Losing a horse is hard. Sorry to hear that.
Yeah. That horse did right by me. Better than my husband. Ugh, will you quit it already? Anyways, right, what is wrong with you? I was saying something. Oh, right, yeah. Man, okay, just let me off. I'll walk from here.
Easy, easy.
Might as well just have left me to walk.
Well, safe travels anyway.
Just can't never get a break.
Slow up now.
Get the hell away from me.
There we go. Can I speak to the boy?
Arthur?
Hello, son. Your sister is very worried.
The boy has chosen a path, sir. The path to truth.
Well, his sister just wants to speak with him.
Arthur, I've chosen a path.
The boy has chosen a path. He's chosen safety. What path have you chosen, sir?
I don't know about this nonsense. Let me speak to the boy.
Dut-dut? Are you always this negative and antagonistic, sir?
Only when dealing with idiots. Now let me talk to the boy! I'm starting to lose my patience with you. Goddamn lunatic!
Stop it, Arthur!
That's enough, Arthur!
Kid, come on. This is crap. You're better than this.
Better than what? Better than one in paradise?
Better than thinking these fools know a damn thing about paradise. Now, let me take you home.
You're a sad man, Arthur. You're a real sad man.
Sure, but come home.
Not a chance! Leave me alone! Arthur, I didn't ask for your help! Yeah.
Damn it, we gotta do this the hard way!
This is none of your damn business! Sorry!
They're just using you! Telling you what you wanna hear!
What the hell do you know about it, Arthur?
For Christ's sakes, Jamie, just hold up a minute!
You pop up out of nowhere?
Yeah. Stop! Let's talk about this!
I was doing just fine by myself!
Come on, Jamie! Your sister's worried about you! Come on! You ain't stupid! You can see this is crazy!
You're the crazy one! I don't have to answer to you! Morgan, leave me alone.
Please, kid, put that gun down.
I warn you, Arthur, I don't want to live anymore.
Kid, just calm down.
Leave me alone.
Calm down! Let's go see your sister.
Okay. Okay.
It's okay, kid.
Have I been a terrible fool, Arthur?
I don't know. I don't know enough about it. But one thing I do know. There ain't no shame in looking for a better world.
I missed you, Arthur. Are you and Mary sweet on one another again?
Oh, no. That's all a long time ago, son. Yeah.
Well, this wasn't how I thought today would turn out.
It's been a long time, Jamie Gillis. You were a kid last time I saw you. You didn't try to kill yourself.
You know, you taught me how to ride a horse.
Too well, apparently. Shalonia, though? Really? You'd fall for that?
They were very nice to me. They're decent.
I'm sure. Please tell me you didn't give them any money.
Of course I did. They rely on charitable donations.
Jesus, Jamie, come on.
I just wanted to believe that there might be something good coming my way one day. Guess that's dead in the water.
with the turtles.
Shut up. All Father kept telling me was, you won't amount to anything. You're not enough of a man. I had to get away. I couldn't take it anymore. Why are we getting off? We're not walking there, are we? So, yeah, where were we?
Forget. Hey, but your father's a bully and a coward. Don't let...
Hey, don't talk about him like that.
What do you want me to say, Jamie? He's a good father, nice man.
He won't be happy I saw you.
Please send him my worst.
Thing is, he's right. I'm not good at anything.
Come on, that ain't true. Tell me something you like. Don't think too hard.
Apples, I guess.
Apples?
Yeah, I love apples.
Okay. I was thinking more along the lines of carpentry or horses or something. All right, go work in an orchard. Okay.
Where are we going? You taking me back to Mary or not? that really necessary?
Just talking about something?
By that token, you must really like shooting and robbing people.
I only like shooting young idiots who run away from me when I'm trying to help them.
Father told me what you do.
I'm sure he did.
Hey, are you still with Dutch and... what was his name? Hester?
Okay. Say, yep, still the same, sort of.
And Annabelle and Bessie?
I'm afraid they're dead.
Shit. Maybe Mary did make the right choice.
No doubt. But none of it is anything like the nonsense you read in the newspapers.
So, are you two getting back together?
I told you. Just asked me for a favor.
You know Barry Lyndon's dead? Pneumonia. Now, I was saying, you know Barry Lyndon's dead? Pneumonia.
He told me.
So the door's open, so to speak.
That's all in the past. Different people now.
She's not. And you seem just the same.
Well, maybe that right there's a problem. She was always too good for me. Let's just get you back to your sister. She's waiting at the station for us. Mister.
Shed enough tears on your account.
We going in then?
Jamie! Oh, come home. Please, Father's been very sad.
Father wouldn't know sadness if it died in his bed. But I'll come home for you.
My boy.
My sweet boy. Come on. Oh, Arthur. Thank you. Thank you.
It's good to see you, Mary.
And you, Arthur. And you. Oh, you'll never change. I know that.
I feel like the luckiest man alive, and I feel like a fool. That woman confuses me and plays me for a fiddle like no one else alive. I trust I will not make a god-awful fool of myself once more, but somehow I imagine I shall.